Dear friends, welcome back. Today we will see how to use the SD card module with Arduino in order to add storage space to our project. So, let's start. The module is very easy to use and the cost of it is very low. It costs around 2.5 euros on eBay. In order to use it, you will also need a micro SD card, this card here. The SD card module is a 3.3 volt device, so it won't tolerate the 5 volt logic levels that Arduino uses. Luckily, most of the modules for Arduino use a 3.3 volt regulator and a logic level shifter so they can work with Arduino. The regulator is this chip here and the logic level shifter is this chip here. Please check your modules for those two chips before connecting them to 5 volt levels. So, the connection of the module is very easy. The module uses the SPI protocol in order to communicate with Arduino. So, we need to use the hardware SPI pins of our Arduino board. On an Arduino Uno, those pins are pins from 13 to 10. Different Arduino boards have different SPI pins. So, be careful. I'll post them in the description of the video. So, let's start connecting the module to an Arduino Uno. There are 7 pins in this module. We only have to connect 6 of them. 4 of them are used for the SPI communication and one is ground and the other is VCC. Ground goes to Arduino ground. VCC goes to Arduino 5 volts. The next pin, MISO, goes to digital pin 12. Pin MOSI goes to digital pin 11. Pin clock goes to digital pin 13. And lastly, pin chip select goes to digital pin 10 on Arduino Uno. This is the only pin that you can change to any digital pin you like. The other pins are fixed. You cannot change them. That's it. Let's go to the computer and see the module working. I have prepared a small program in order to test the read and write functionality of the SD card module. It uses the standard SD.h library. I just developed some easy to use functions in order to make writing to the SD and reading from the SD card easier. Let's see the code. First, we initialize the SD card. Then, we create a file named test.txt. If the file exists, it will be opened. If it doesn't exist, it will be created. Then we write a small text in the file. And then we close it. Only one file can be opened at any time, so we have to close files that we don't use. Then we will try to open a file named prefs.txt that already exists in the SD card and read some lines from it. Then, of course, we have to close the file. Each function prints something to the serial monitor in order to be able to check if everything is working as expected. Let's now upload the program to Arduino and see the output at the serial monitor. Okay, the program is now loaded to Arduino. Let's open the serial monitor and see the output. As you can see, the SD card is initialized, is ready to use. We have created a file successfully and we are adding to the file the sample text. Then the file is closed and then we open the preferences file. The file is opened and we read two lines, line 1 and line 2. And then we close the file. Let's now connect the SD card to computer and see what it contains. As you can see, the SD card contains two files. One file is named test.txt as the file we have created in code, and inside it there is the sample text that we have printed. That's it. Next is the prefs.txt file, which was created manually in the beginning. Inside it I have placed 5 lines of data, line 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. And in the code, all we do is we read the first two lines of this file, and then we close it. As you can see, everything is working fine.
That's today's video, a really useful functionality that we are going to use in many future projects. In order to log data from sensor, to save project preferences or store data for games. With this module, we can build more complex projects from now on. So stay tuned. Before we go, I will show you another small footage from Laconia. If you like the video, press like and subscribe to our channel in order to watch our future projects. See you next week!